All right, well, let's talk about your career a little bit, Keem. How did you find yourself being the number one drama channel on YouTube? How did you find yourself in that position?
Do you want me to start from the very beginning?
Let's start with Blog TV.
Well, it'll take a little bit to get there, but I did legal collections at an attorney's office. I was pretty good at my goddamn job, and I would get a bonus check for hitting different quotas and stuff. Got big fucking bonus check. Took everyone in the office out for drinks, got completely wasted, went home, got on Xbox Live and just started talking shit to people because that's what I like to do. Mm-hmm. And I was especially really drunk. So I'm telling this guy, I'm like, I'm going to bend your grandmother over my knee, shave her ass hair, roll it up in a blunt and make you smoke it. Like I'm saying foul shit, right? Mm-hmm. I didn't know this, but a guy in my game was recording me. I had no idea.
Right.
So like the next day I get on Xbox Live and my messages are filled. Seen you on YouTube. I'm like, I'm not on YouTube. What is this? Right. I find the video and I'm like, oh my God. So I reach out to the guy cause I was going to ask him to delete it cause I didn't want it to affect my job.
Yeah.
He goes, dude, you're the funniest dude. Like I've ever heard, best trash talker. He's like, you should make videos with us. We just formed this group. We're like, you know, messing with kids, talking trash to them in this game. So I went from asking him to delete it to being like,
then like joining it.
Okay. Yeah. Like, yeah. So I started doing that. And within 3 months, Machinima offered me a contract because you couldn't get paid back then for mm-hmm. gaming content. You just did it for the love of the game, yeah. You know? Machinima offered me a contract within 3 months, started my own YouTube channel. It just blew up.
What year was around the time that you first started your YouTube channel?
It would have been January of 2009.
And it was it on your own channel or was it on that group?
Well, we had our own individual channels and then we had a group channel.
Okay, yeah, yeah.
And so we were the first, I mean, obviously there was gaming trolling videos and mm-hmm. content like that.
There was like good grief
prior to us, right? But we were the first ones to like have a channel based on that. Like mm-hmm. all of our content was based on that.
Yep.
You know, so you'd go into a game, someone call you a faggot or whatever, right?
Sure.
Oh, now we're gonna fuck with this dude. We're gonna betray him. You know, we're gonna get him to betray us. And we're gonna be like, yo, what's the shape of Italy? Boo! And then we kick him from the game because he's betrayed us. Like just shit like that. So
this is on Halo.
Yeah, all on Halo 3. So we were the first ones that did that. Our channel blew up. I mean, we got 250,000 subscribers, which back then
was huge. Like in
2009, that was like literally having like, I don't know, 10 million subs today, right?
Yeah.
After a while of doing this, people didn't believe us. They were like, oh, your videos are staged. You know, the main meme back then was fake and gay. Oh, yeah, this is fake and gay.
Ray William Johnson to you.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. So I had to prove people that we were doing these pranks. These pranks were real. So I started streaming over on Blog TV
mm-hmm.
and, I was doing all my pranks and all my trolling and all my trash talking and all my different characters that I would do in Halo 3 in front of a live audience, pulling anywhere between 2,000 and 3,000 people every single night.
That is insane.
That's very crazy good.
For back then.
Yeah, that was the late 2009, summer of 2010. So on that site, Blog TV, there was the Shaytards, Shane Dawson, mm-hmm. Philip DeFranco. Everybody kind of had a Blog TV deal. And Shay Carl or Philip DeFranco was number one when I started over there. And in a matter of like 3 months, I became number one on Blog TV. Like that was like my platform. So I did very good with that, trolling and doing all that live stuff. Eventually at some point, like, Xbox Live started banning all my Xboxes. I mean, like every fucking day, it was like religious to me. Go to GameStop, buy a brand new Xbox.
Wow.
So
go home.
Once the account's banned, you can't use that Xbox anymore?
You can't use the Xbox. They would ban the Xbox.
Oh my God.
Jesus Christ.
So in order to make my videos, I'd have to like try to hide my username, right? Jeez. It's because the Xbox moderator who... he was doxed and everything. His name was Steve, but I can't think of his last name, which whatever. He would go on to every single stream because they were trying to stop this trolling. They were trying to stop...
trying to stop cyberbullying.
Microsoft was trying to stop everything that made gaming fun. Like, just... that's why they lost to Sony, period. But... so they were trying to stop that by banning me. And so what I would do is I would stream for about 1 hour, get banned, console banned, can't do anything with it. It's a bricked, it's literally banned from going online. Take that the next day to GameStop, return it. Hey, this didn't work. Get a new one. Then the next day it would be Walmart and I would just switch places just so I could keep doing it. That became so stressful and so much hell that I needed to find something else to do because Microsoft was trying to shut me down. So there was this website called Battlecam, right? And I would go over on Battlecam and that wasn't gaming at all. That was just live, you know, talking trash to each other. And there was one spot where you could cam up and everybody would have to be in this lineup and the viewers would vote if that person stays up or gets voted down, right?
So it's like a 1v1 verbal battle kind of thing.
Yeah, right. Yeah. So what I would do is I'd go over there, but I would also be live streaming on Blog TV. Mm. I'd come over with 2,000 people. They would all upvote me and I would hijack the website. So nobody could kick me off.
Yeah. Amazing.
I would sit there for like 2 hours straight talking shit to every single one of those people that cammed up normally. They couldn't even respond.
Damn. So
what kind of people were they? Like, were they just regular guys?
Boomers, or? White trash, right. Like just some young kids, like every different, you know, race, every different age group, every different,
so,
like.
So the idea of battle cams is you get on a webcam and you talk shit to each other and the audience decides who talked the best shit.
The audience decides who stays up. Yeah.
Is there anything like that around today?
I don't think so. That's a fucking great idea.
No, it's a great idea. So it was created by Elky David, who's an eccentric billionaire, right? Hmm. And so Elky David went over on Twitch at the time. And he had, like, you know, all his hot wives and stuff twerking or whatever. And Twitch banned him. And so he's like, fuck Twitch. I'm going to create my own site. And he created Battlecam.
Was it Justin.tv at the time?
Yeah. But people don't remember that. So that's just said Twitch. But so, his whole idea was I'm going to make a live stream platform where anything goes.
Right.
So, like, these people on camera showing their face would be calling each other the F words, the N words, like everything. Genius. Whatever race you were, people said racist stuff to you, you know? Mm-hmm. So it was an all out war and it was fun. I loved it because I had such a big fan base that I could just bully everyone there. But eventually Elky made me a moderator because I brought so many viewers over to the website, right? And there was this other guy, Alex, who was also a moderator. So what happened was, is when you're a moderator, you can start anyone and you can kick anyone.
So
from
what's
the
idea? So starting is just putting somebody up.
Okay. Let's say we're all in the lineup, right?
Okay.
I'm first, you're second, all the way around, right? Yep. A moderator can put him in the front of the line and just make him go up on the camera.
Right.
You know? Or he can kick him out or whatever, right? You have all these controls. I'm a moderator. Alex is a moderator and Elky David is not there. There's no one there. So what Alex starts doing is he starts starting me over and over again. When I'm waiting, I'm being a good boy, I'm waiting in the lineup for my turn, and he keeps starting me. So to the audience, it looks like I'm starting myself.
Yeah. So that's why you say, I'm not starting my fucking self.
Yeah, so the whole time he's doing this, I'm like, dude, I'm not starting myself in the chat. My fans are saying that. You know, Alex is doing this shit, da-da-da-da. And Alex is sitting there calling me, you know, a dago, a wop, because I'm Italian, and this is just like a normal part of this website. You know, everyone's racist.
Guinea wop, bro.
Yeah. True.
A little Italian moment there for you.
Hell yeah.
Hey, give me a coffee.
Coffee pot. Great. Copper coffee pot, yeah.
So what I did is I went and I live streamed on Blog TV, proving that I was not starting myself, you know? My hands were up in the air. Yes. Oh. Told my fans to, you know, spam Alex with the N-word, you know, to fire back because he was calling me a dago, a wop. And so that's basically what that clip is.
Yeah. Crazy.
Yeah, so for anyone watching or listening who doesn't know what this meme is, there's basically just this clip.
just look up Keemstar N-word.
Yeah, just look up Keemstar N-word and you'll see. It's something that happened so long ago.
It's a fantastic piece of internet history. It's a golden video. Just the way you said the N-word with such passion.
Well, look,
really drove it home.
Obviously, anyone with a brain cell left, like, will like defend you on this one and say like, oh, it was no big deal.
Yeah, dude, I really wasn't. Well, you're cool with Alex anyways now, right?
Sure. No, I hate him. He deserved it. He deserved everything. Okay. I don't like Alex.
Guys, if you're watching this,
fuck you.
I've actually never heard the story. I didn't know the full story.
Neither did I.
I'm actually glad I saved it for the podcast.